Welcome to our course of our apps from B to S. In this video, we will talk about the Dataverse basics as lesson 1 on module 3, working with Dataverse. Let me first list the lesson outline. In this lesson, we will talk about what is the Dataverse and how it is related to Power Apps. After that, we will list the benefits of using Dataverse. Then we will talk about Dataverse and Power Apps. What Dataverse mean to Power Apps? At the end of this video, we will explore the different ways to import and export data into Dataverse and how to use these ways in Power Apps. Let's begin our lesson with what is the Dataverse in general. Actually, Dataverse is a straightforward platform that you can use to begin designing your data structures. Dataverse is a cloud-based storage space that organizations can use to store business application data. Dataverse uses Azure Active Directory identity and the access management mechanism to help ensure that only authorized users can access the environment, data, and reports. The data within Dataverse is stored within a set of tables. The table is a set of records, or we can say rows, that used to store data, similar to how a table stores data within a database. These tables are divided into standard tables and custom tables. The standard tables are built-in tables that cover typical scenarios, and the custom tables, you can create these tables that are specific to your organization, and you will populate them with Dataverse data using Power Query. Now we will list the main benefits of Dataverse. One of these benefits is how Dataverse is easy to manage, as both the metadata and the data are stored in the cloud, so Dataverse brings together your business data in one place. Another benefit is how easy is Dataverse is secure. Dataverse is a secure cloud-based storage space that organizations can use to store business application data. The Dataverse uses Azure Active Directory identity and the access management mechanism to help ensure that only authorized users can access the environment and the data and the reports. Dataverse works with any type of data, relational or non-relational data. It can work with files, images, or data lake, and connecting to other services that contain the data for your business. Also, Dataverse can work with any type of apps, as it provides multiple ways to integrate in any type of app, mobile, web, desktop, device, system, or service. Another benefit is the rich metadata that including in Dataverse, and access your Dynamics 365 data. If you use Dynamics 365, so the data from your Dynamics 365 application is also stored within Dataverse. And that allow you to quickly build the applications that use your Dynamics 365 data. Dataverse is integrated into popular tools such as Excel, Outlook, Power BI Desktop, Power Query, Azure Data Factory, Data Export Service, and SQL Server Management Studio. The Dataverse allows you to easily apply business logic at the data level. Also, Dataverse has the ability to create charts and paginated reports, and it can be used with Power BI to create rich and interactive reports and dashboards. This is Dataverse in general. Now, we will talk about the Dataverse in Power Apps. Dataverse is an option of data sources that you can use within Power Apps. So, app makers can then use Dataverse to build rich applications in Power Apps. In Power Apps, each environment can have only one common data service database, the Dataverse database. And the Dataverse considers securely stored for business applications built on Power Apps. Dataverse also allows data to be integrated from multiple sources into a single store, which can then be used in Power Apps. In Power Apps, you can use Dataverse standard table, which are built in, and custom table, which your organization create, or both. Dataverse is a great option for Power Apps. Now, what about the cost to use Dataverse in Power Apps? Actually, if you are using PowerApps, then the license will cover Dataverse, so you don't have to pay extra. Within PowerApps, the Dataverse database common data service database can be provisioned by you or licensed individual in your organization. This is Dataverse in PowerApps. Without the Dataverse in PowerApps, you can't build model-driven apps, and also you can't build portal apps. This is the Dataverse in PowerApps. Now we will learn the different ways to import and export data into Dataverse. Actually, there are many ways to import and export data into Dataverse. You can use Dataflow, Power Query, Azure Data Factory, Azure Logic Apps, and Power Automate. We will explore now how to use these ways to import and export data for Dataverse to use within PowerApps. We will divide PowerApps to app and portal. So, in loading data into Dataverse, you can build your PowerApps app that stores data in Dataverse table. And for portal, you can create a data flow and schedule it to load data into Dataverse. In retrieving data from Dataverse for apps, you can build forms in your app that extract and display data from the Dataverse. And for portal, you can use export data option for the portal. Let's take a look for the Dataverse. First, we have to know that to deal with Dataverse, the common data service before, we must have an environment with database. You can find the tables for the Dataverse from the data section in the tables. Here it will list for you the tables, the standard tables and the custom tables. As we said that the standard is built in tables that cover scenarios that made by Microsoft itself, and the custom tables that you can perform for your organization. Also, if you have a Dataverse environment, the common data service environment, you will find the solutions section. Later we will discuss all of this in more details. Let's switch for environment without database. If you try to open the tables section, no solution found, you need a database. Also, the solutions here is empty. So, to deal with Dataverse, you must have environment with database. Also, without environment with database, you can't create model-driven apps and you can't create portals apps. Back to our lesson. Now, we finished the first lesson, Dataverse Basics, that we have learned what is the Dataverse and what is the main benefits of using Dataverse and what is the common relationship between PowerApps and Dataverse and how to import and export data within Dataverse. Next, we will working with Dataverse tables, the common data service entities before.